they were all beauties. And we're underway, the defending Stanley Cup champs against the Red Wings. The Stanley Cup champs are without Keith Cox tonight, and Anze Kopitar and Marian Gaborik, who are both injured. Trevor Lewis returns to their lineup tonight for them. Joakim Andersson plays one back to Kaiser, a shot, and it's blocked in front. For the umpteenth time this season, Luke Glendening's lost his helmet.
That's really the key for most of this stuff. No icing there. That's it.
Here's Zetterberg shooting one. Glanced off a leg. Interfered with in front, was abdicated. Pass one around and behind for the Red Wing captain. Zetterberg checked by Regier. Alec Martinez couldn't clear it out. Held into the line. Cronwall shot. That'll be held by Jonathan Quick. Sandwiched around a six-game home victory streak.
Ooh.
There in Helm. Get up at center is Helm.
He got corked at center ice and he might go off.
Right now his first job is to check Jordan Nolan. His Helm now gingerly went to the Red Wing bench.
And it's no wonder we got a million concussions in the league with hits like that.
Shot in on Quick. And credit Drew Miller.
As they say, Darryl is a man of few words and a lot of faces.
Yes, that's for sure.
He's soft-spoken. Maybe not so many times in the dressing room when things aren't going well, but...
Whether the Kings won or lost in the playoff, I just look forward to the postgame.
Oh, I know.
And the news conference. Good play there. Datsyuk to Abdicator. Three on one. Abdicator's up. Datsyuk behind. Abdicator shooting. And that was stopped by Quick. Well, you can see the confidence Abdicator has taking that shot with Datsyuk and Zetterberg with him. Tipped in front, Zetterberg. Saved by Quick. As Mickey had mentioned how fast he is going side to side. Showed you some of that right there.
You really have to get traffic in front of Quick. Like most goaltenders, he's taken away the bottom of the ice with those pads. But you've got to get second opportunities, too.
Whoa! Oh, collision. Wow. Brandon Smith went down as he was checked by Trevor Lewis. Want to make his presence felt early, and Smith went right back at Lewis this time. Now there's going to be a penalty upcoming here to Los Angeles. And the referees tonight, Paul Dvorsky and Kyle Raymond.
Like Matt Green. So they're really looking for anything they can to grab onto to get this power play going on a regular basis.
And the guys who have the power play goals are out there now. Datsyuk has one. Nyquist has two of them. There's Nyquist. Make it three of them. 1-0. Power play goal. His sixth goal of the season. And his third on the power play.
This is the new rule. That puck before the faceoff went off a Red Wing player. That means the faceoff stayed inside. They win the draw. That's it. But watch the bang bang play here. Here's your guy. Going down, bang, and into the net. I mean, this thing all happened in milliseconds. No handling the puck. Look at Zetterberg. Right off the tape. Right to Nyquist. And Abdicator with a good screen in front of Quick. It wasn't a hard shot, but it was perfectly placed underneath the pads. Really good puck movement. Third power play goal of the season for Gustav Nyquist.
Kaiser circles the goal with it. Williams out front, saved by Howard. On a chance there by Justin Williams. Well, Mr. Hockey Gordie Howe is watching the game tonight from his daughter's home in Lubbock, Texas. And Gordie, we hear from son Mark, you're getting better by the day. Our television family and all Red Wing fans worldwide and here at the Joe miss you. Here's Eric Friday.
Ladies and gentlemen, after an unforgettable career filled with Stanley Cup championships, record-breaking moments, and some of the fiercest on-ice battles the National Hockey League has ever seen, number 9, Gordie Howe, has met his toughest battle yet. This past Sunday, the patriarch of our Red Wings family suffered a significant stroke while residing at his daughter's home in Lubbock, Texas. Gordie is resting comfortably in Texas with all four of his children by his side, where he is watching tonight's game. We here in Hockey Town want to pass our best wishes, thoughts, and prayers to a member of our family. So at this time, may we ask that you please rise in celebration and support for one of the greatest hockey legends to play the game, and let him hear you this evening, Mr. Hockey, Gordie Howe.
for good reason, Gordy. They chanted his name, Ken, at Comerica, if you remember.
Yes.
I know you remember. When he was center ice, said, well, we got a kick out of that down on the ice. He had Ted Lindsay dropping the puck.
Well, how about here when he made the last of his 23 All-Star Game appearances in 1980 and the ovation in this building went up for on and on. It was remarkable.
Still remember him standing at the blue line here at the Joe.
We miss you, Gordy. Get well soon, and we know you're the fighter. And getting better by the day. Brought back the other way by Mike Richards. Richards up with Kyle Clifford. Richards takes the shot, now shoots. Howard made the save. He's down, and the puck is underneath.
Well, Jimmy Howard, hearing it from the appreciative fans here, that was too close for comfort for sure. Puck up behind him, but somehow he was able to roll over and get it before the white jerseys. The Kings trying to get this thing tied up, and Howard scrambling around there.
Back just to
in front of him a couple weeks.
Yep, that's right.
No, they're very happy with the record. There's 10
Look
games.
At that steal by him. Datsyuk waits. Oh. Scores! Datsyuk gets the goal! Rewarded for a great effort, and it's 2-0.
That's why it's nice to have him back in the lineup. Jake Muzzin's trying to find a place to hide, but not much you can do about this. Here's one of his many steals right there. Look at this guy. He is an absolute robber on Dwight King. And he's trying to pass the puck to Abdelkader, or Dedeberg rather, and it went off Muzzin and underneath the goaltender. Good fortune for a great hockey player. Oh, boy.
He's got points in all five games he's played now. 3 goals and 6 points in 5 games for Pavel Datsyuk, and it is 2-0.
Datsyuk now back-to-back, and this goal right here. I was talking to him in the dressing room before the game, and I said, you really picked that top corner. There wasn't much there over Holtby, and he stood there, and he closed his eyes. He went, I shoot, closed my eyes. I said, yeah, right. You knew exactly what you were doing. And there a moment ago, he steals. He leads the league in steals, or is at the top of the class with steals every year.
Muzzin, pounded by Helm. Thomas Yurko, Helm's got it now. Helm circles the goal out front. Loose! And Yurko had an opportunity, but a hooking call on Los Angeles. The Red Wings are going to go to a power play. Nyquist in the slot, Abdelkader in front of Quick. Cronwall, Zetterberg, one-timer, and a piece of that by Quick with the right arm. Knocked down by Gus Nyquist. Zetterberg to Nyquist. The Datsyuk, the Cronwall, just wide, top end goal! Nyquist, it's 3-0!
Boy, oh boy, what is going on, they're wondering. Gus Nyquist ends up with an open net, but absolute mastery of passing back and forth. This puck missed the net completely, and Nyquist got in behind the defenseman Green and had a wide open net. Nothing Quick could do. He didn't know where the puck was. Never saw it.
Back of Kindle. Tatar gathering speed into the King's zone for Nyquist. That was blocked. Tatar's got it again to Shane. Back to Nyquist. Stepping around Regeer. Back in front. Scores! Tatar! Great pass from Nyquist.
Well, once again, it's the speed, speed, speed of the Red Wings that is causing all kinds of problems for the Kings. And Nyquist, wow, he avoided that check by Robin Regeer and went back to the short side, the old Henry Richard play, and Tatar, who has had trouble putting fight in the back of the net, gets his first in 7 games. Second of the season. So, what a night for Nyquist. But that speed again, Ken, is just amazing.
Glendening. The Anderson saved by Quick.
One more goal and quick, Mike.
Out of the corner, Tatar to Sheehan. Goal post. Wow. He rattled the iron.
Are gone from that cup-winning team, so they've kept the core group together, and for the most part, pretty much together from the previous cup. Hurt, though, is Justin Williams. Looked like a right hip as he went heavily into the end boards. He'll make his way hunched over to the Kings bench as Quick will hold on to that. The Kaiser backpedaling for Kendall. Across center and in as Nyquist jumped to get out of the way. Let go there to Datsyuk. To Zetterberg. To Datsyuk. Oh. Oh, and Quick got over. Oh, was that smartly set up. The Euro Twins combining there on a great chance. Zetterberg again. Take the shot. And Doughty went to block. Cronwall firing.
Wow. Right into the trap. Right into the catching
zone.
No, he didn't. It was perfectly placed. That's a good position by Jonathan Quick. They got a couple of guys with concussions that continue to be a real bugaboo.
And you've got the Bruin injury situation and the Blue Jackets. Howard has scored it free. And they score. They bang it in. Martinez from his knees got a backhand shot through that eluded Howard, who's still wondering how that got through. He didn't have his stick. And then maybe found the only spot, Mick, that it could have.
Well, I think
the Kings within three.
I think they were looking for that puck to be ruled dead. It was just good. See right here. I don't know. I mean, in real time, they just didn't stop, because you don't stop in this game until you hear the whistle. And it was Richards that dug it out. Howard had it covered. There isn't any question about that. What's the time here? They're looking for that whistle to go.
And if you looked at the referee in the corner, the whistle was up to his mouth.
Yeah.
He was about to blow it, but didn't.
Yeah, again, you know, if you're playing this game, I don't care what level you're at, you just keep going until you hear the whistle.
But it'll be no icing because the King Brown gets there first. Dustin Brown looks to the net. Off a leg. Backhanded Howard. It'll be Quick there with the pads to make that save. Jeez. Big collision back in the Red Wing zone.
I guess so.
Once again, it's Glendening and Brown, and they've come together a few times tonight.
Brown went after him this time with a purpose. It wasn't just an incidental hit.
Richards, Lewis, and Clifford up as it's stolen here. And good save there by Quick as he was able to stop Riley Sheehan, who gives it back to Tatar. Sheehan's got it, knocked it out of the air, and he just couldn't get it to settle down to lift it over Quick. Sheehan left it there for Nyquist. Nyquist with a good spin back. Back to Sheehan, and it just hopped over his stick, then lost his twig. 25 runs. And have since allowed two power play goals. The Kings are in. Howard the save. Look behind him. And he's got it. Long enough.
What a nicely set up scoring chance. Holy smoke. You can see why this line is so productive. I mean, they bring him in late, Carter.
Reaching in there was Pearson. It came back for Carter. Pearson sets up in front of Howard to Foley in the slot. Pearson went looking for it. It's loose side of the goal. Threw it out front. Muzzin the shot. Blocked in front. Glendening. Muzzin. Going down was Carter and spinning around to clear it is Miller. Tipped ahead by Erickson. Brought on here by Anderson. To Helm. And a save by Quick. Boy, Helm could have kept on skating.
He could have.
Martinez, top of the circle, broke his stick. But Richards has it. Front of the goal, big crowd, and it didn't get through. And a chance for Williams.
Another penalty, Detroit.
With 2 seconds remaining in the Nyquist penalty and 61 seconds to go in the second period.
Yeah, and there's not much question about this call either.
Carter to Foley and Pearson and Doughty and Muzzin. Anderson, the lone forward for Detroit. Nyquist out of the box. Just tipped wide of the goal. Howard scrambling to get back in. Point shot. Muzzin missed the net. Off the backboards. Richards. Or that was Pearson jamming away at it. Wouldn't go. Helm and applicator for the Wings up front. The penalty kill situation. Back in front of the goal. Howard. Big save.
Wow. Before anybody even... 28.
commits to lay a game.
Moved on it. There it is. It didn't hit it by much. He didn't hit it by much. And Stoll's a very good faceoff man.
Was it Joakim Andersen the other few games
ago? It was, yeah.
Had that two games ago. Yep. Right back into his own zone for Martinez. And the Kings goal scorer tonight gets it down the ice. Dwight King for Los Angeles with a shot that Howard stops. Gave it to Zetterberg, wanted to keep the play moving. Regier with a shot, Howard to save, and they score! Boy, he wanted to keep it moving rather than to hold it, and it backfired. And Tyler Toffoli makes it a 4-2 game, the Kings' third shorthanded goal of the season.
Well, if that doesn't wake the Red Wings up, nothing will. They know darn well now the Kings are within striking range. But they just kept getting the loose puck. It got dumped down knee twice in the corner. And as you picked up, Ken, the communication right here, because they're on a power play, is the reason that he didn't hold it for the whistle. That's exactly what happened. And it went through Zetterberg's feet. And it starts it off right there. It'll go back in the corner again. And boom. Right into the back of the net. Toffoli. So the big line keeps getting bigger. 18th goal for the line they call the 70s line. Carter, Pearson, and Toffoli.
A tough drop-off from Howard to Zetterberg for him to handle.
Tarr
couldn't get through, and it's a break for Dustin Brown. He's in the clear. Oh, he's tripped. There's no call on the ball. Yeah. Now there is. Penalty shot.
It was definitely a late call. No question about that.
A shorthanded penalty shot for the Kings captain, Dustin Brown. Paul Dvorsky had no arm in the air for a tripping call. He was waiting until the play was done, then signaled penalty shot.
And this is what happens when you don't move the puck precisely and quickly as the last man. He waited a long time to make that call. Here we go.
Jimmy Howard facing another penalty shot, and he stops it.
Wow.
He now in the regular season, he is 10-11 of 16. He's faced 16 penalty shots in the regular season, and he stopped 11 of them.
I'm not sure where Dustin Brown was trying to go. He tried to go five hole. He got it up too high and hit him right in the belly. That was a huge situation for Detroit. If he scores there, I'm telling you.
Helm got it into Yurko. Back to the line, and the Kaiser let it go. Helm put it in. He was hit hard again.
Good Lord.
Going to be a penalty here.
Good Lord.
And coming to his aid, and rightfully so, as they go after Jordan Nolan. Erickson came in quickly. Now Helm mixing it up. He's in there with Andy Andreoff. They did not like that hit.
Well,
and the crowd likes the fact that the big defenseman came to his aid with Jordan Olsen, Jonathan Erickson.
Well, this is a hit that could end up in a five-minute major in the game of conduct because his face was in the glass. Just a semi-bit sideways, but he didn't know he was coming. It's a blind hit, and Nolan is one big drink of water. Big time. Oh, boy. That's a heavy, heavy hit. Wow. And that's the reason for all of that. I wonder if Darren Helm got up.
Five consecutive wins over L.A. Yeah. Here at the Joe coming into play tonight.
And that play will end up in...
Katsuk spinning back. Saved by Quick.
The change in the rules. That and a few others. Well, it's been a strong game for Pavel Datsyuk. He likes to fake to the outside, come back to the middle.
Played it to the line, but not out. Kindle held it in. Good stick lift there by Glendening. That allows Anderson to put it on goal. Glendening, oh, and he gets punched. And the net is lost. And there was no call on that play. It's a two-goal lead now for the Red Wings as Glendening came close to making a three-goal advantage again. Change here for the Red Wings as Drew Doughty with his head up. Lost the puck. Stolen by Datsyuk. Oh, and a piece of that by Quick and a penalty upcoming. Advocator comes in. Howard to the bench for an extra skater. Zetterberg put it back in front. And the Kings touch.
LA penalty,
Drew Doughty had a problem finding it. And then, that's a hook. Oh, boy. You were lucky to be on the receiving end of that one.
I guess so.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
I guess so. You can't find the handle. It says it's super slow-mo. But, I mean... Okay.
He's thinking, yeah, that hook will not slow down Pavel Datsyuk.
Honest to goodness, yeah.
Kindle able to keep it in. Just got it across for Tatar. Nyquist to Shane. Didn't get there. Muzzin blocked. Humped it off to Tatar. Goes back to the line here. Cronwall. Tatar in tight. Look at a one-time that. Look like a Brett Hull style.
It was.
Left side.
An 80-mile-an-hour,
yeah,
one-timer.
Quickly out of the zone for Toffoli. Pearson to the goal as Toffoli shoots the rebound. Good tie up in front goal. They jam in back of the net. Out of the crowd of it. Glendening to Smith. Didn't get what he wanted on that. Puck goes off to the corner for Anderson. Regier on him to the slot. The shot.
Jeez.
And a hard one from Glendening. Stopped by Quick.
Get back. Puck free.
White King for LA. Gets shoved there by Helm. Holding the line was Kindle, and Nestrosil's got it. Fights off a check. Nestrosil to the middle of the shot, save. Rebound for Yurko. Another shot. It's loose. Nestrosil can't bury it, and Quick's got it in a bid for his first National Hockey League goal.
Oh, you got to wonder how Jonathan Quick makes saves like these. Holy mackerel. Unbelievable. He's way out of the crease. Any deals made for him is going to take half of Wall Street to get it, to get him.
They want prospects and picks and good prospects. Here's Zetterberg with a try.
Exactly.
Quick's going to the bench.
Yeah.
With 2:25 to play. Extra skater for Los Angeles. Their net is empty. Down by two goals. And a chance to get within one, but a save by Howard.
That's a heck of a chance, too.
A Dwight King opportunity.
But neither does this guy. And look at this highlight film right here of the work Pavel Datsyuk. A little shelf for number 8. Going to the net. He's absolute robbery doing things like this all night long. Creating scoring chances. Go. Thrifty around the net. Another steal here off of King. Got the break off of Muzzin's foot. There's a second Red Wing goal. It's been a really good night for Mr. Datsyuk again. No surprise though.
Again for LA. Datsyuk cleared it to the line, but Pearson held it in, blocked in front. Brendan Smith for Zetterberg.
Look at this.
For Applicator. Brooks for Zetterberg, tipped to Datsyuk, and he scores! All three, and on that one, Datsyuk from Zetterberg and Applicator.
Well, I didn't get that in my highlight reel of you.
He's got two tonight, and a point in every game he's played.
Multiple point nights are becoming a regularity with Pavel Datsyuk. He didn't waste any time doing that. He was working on those sticks tonight before the game and told me it's not exactly what he wants, but it's close enough.
4 goals and 8 points in 5 games for Pavel Datsyuk.
He can do that.
50th consecutive sellout crowd, many departing and singing on their way out of the Joe. As the Red Wings will win this one.
There'd be a very slight chance, a lot of pundits, that they're going to make the playoffs for the 24th straight year. And you saw all the teams that they were playing back-to-back with Toronto, Montreal, Pittsburgh, LA, in Washington, in Philly. And they're going to end up with 14 out of 20 points. Even though there's 2 points in losses, overtime or shootouts, it's like 7 wins out of 10. Pretty impressive.
It's been a fun month.
It has, sure.
Exciting month for sure as we'll begin November and the Red Wings in a good spot. As the crowd cheers the Red Wings in a 5-2 win.
Well, it's a great night for Datsyuk. Good night for Jimmy Howard. He stops the penalty shot and is good when he needed to be. The Kings get 30 shots for Detroit's 35. But Tuss Nyquist is our Miller Moments provider as he gets 2 again tonight. Both on the power play. What a tic-tac-toe play that was. And his goal will be the winning goal. of a 5-2 Red Wing win here at the Joe.
In that first period, the Red Wings with four goals in 9 minutes and 23 seconds. And that third goal means Gus Nyquist has another game winner, his second of the season. And a big night again for Pavel Datsyuk as the Red Wings outshoot the Kings 35-30. Eric Freining now with their three stars.
Star number three from Detroit, number 35, Jimmy Howard. Star number two, also from Detroit, number 13, Pavel Datsyuk. And star number one from Detroit, number 14, Gustav Nyquist.
Two tonight and three is past two after going four without after starting the season with goals in the first four games for Gus Nyquist.